We have a nation right now that's got some real challenges. We've now had 4 years in a row with a president that's built trillion-dollar deficits. It's bad economics. It's the wrong course for America. And I believe it's immoral for us to pass on our burdens on to the next generation. Now, the president promised that he was going to cut the deficit in half. Yeah, it didn't happen, did it? He's more than doubled it. He's added almost as much debt held by the public, $5 trillion, as all the prior presidents of the country combined. And when you look at all of the debt of the country, why, it's about the size of our entire economy. This puts us on a path to become like Europe. You see, we don't have to guess what the future looks like if we stay with the current president. We can see what's happening over in Europe. And what's happening over there is that people have spent more than they have taken in year after year after year, borrowed more and more money, made promises they couldn't fulfill, and finally, something which had to end did end. And what happened there was that the government had to pull back with severe austerity programs, and people in government and the private sector lost their jobs. 25% unemployment rate, 25% in Spain. Think of that. These are the kinds of circumstances that can arrive here if we stay on the path we're on. And that's why it's so critical in this election to decide whether we're going to have an America like Europe or whether we're going to have an America that lives by the principles upon which we were founded and balances budgets, lives within our means, and creates a bright future for our children. Energy, education, the skills we need to succeed, trade, balancing our budget, and championing small business, they're going to cause this economy to come roaring back. People around the world are going to be surprised to see America lead the world again with economic growth and vitality. And every parent is going to know their child is going to get the education they need to succeed, and there's a job waiting for them when they come out of school. That's what our future is going to be. That plan creates 12 million jobs in 4 years, and we need them, and I'll get them, and we'll have more take-home pay to go with it.